Good evening. Good to have you with us in the 8 p.m. edition of the Urban Debate. Tonight, we put the spotlight again on the ongoing parliament session. In a sense, it's ongoing. Unfortunately, it's not going anywhere because there are so many disruptions. There's constant disruption, constant sloganeering, protests and adjournments, with the houses not being able to function at all. Now, before we go further and discuss the politics of it, take a look at these numbers. This shows you, gives you a sense of the kind of productivity that we've looked at this parliament monsoon session. Just about 14% productivity. Total functioning days, 10 on paper, barring the weekends and a few other holidays. But the actual functioning out of these days has actually been less than 9 hours. Less than 9 hours. How much of time have they spent on bills, discussing bills? Just about an hour and few minutes. About 6 bills have been passed, but with barely any attendance inside the parliament houses, inside Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha, and with barely any kind of discussion. This is Lok Sabha. If you look at Rajya Sabha, similarly, the productivity there, 21%. Total functioning days, 10. Actual functioning hours, only 12 hours. 5 bills passed, 1.9 hours spent on these bills. Now, these are just a segment of what the parliament, either of the two houses, should be doing. What you and I expect our parliamentarians to do when they get together a few times in a year is to discuss the biggest of the issues plaguing the country, is to discuss various policies, various laws that are being brought in, policies that need to be changed. Where are we lagging? Where are we doing well? What is the impact of the pandemic? What is happening within the economy? Creation of jobs, rising fuel prices, rising inflation, and all of that. But this hasn't happened because the opposition has constantly just said, we want the discussion to be held in a certain manner. We want the discussion on Pegasus. Now they're talking about fuel prices. And if you're not going to do it as per our wishes, then there won't be any House proceedings. Today, Rahul Gandhi hosted a breakfast meeting at the Constitution Club of India. About 14 of the opposition parties, including the Congress, actually participated in this meeting, which was, in a sense, opposition's show of strength. They discussed what is to be done in the parliament. By the looks of it, they discuss how is the parliament to be obstructed from here on as well. Now, for the last many, many days, especially since the Pegasus story broke, the opposition's focus, and especially Congress that's been leading their protests, has been more about Pegasus, demanding accountability, demanding answers to specific questions, demanding a probe into Pegasus. Today, at least, they spoke about farm laws and price rise and created ruckus in both the houses. The Prime Minister, for the second straight time now in the last 10 days itself, has expressed his disappointment, his anger over the opposition's behaviour in the parliament. He even went on to say that those who tore papers and threw it remain unrepentant. He was very direct to highlight that one instance that took place inside the parliament when the minister was speaking, stood up to give an answer, an update on a crucial issue. The MPs barged into the well. One of them took the paper from his hand and tore it off. He also said that the opposition's behavior just shows their arrogance. The comments that are being made by certain MPs are derogatory to the parliament procedure. So the Prime Minister himself making it extremely clear that the government is not going to take this lying down. He also blamed the opposition for not wanting to have meaningful debates. Now, what I've done here is essentially describe to you the two sides. I've tried to bring out how the two sides are only hardening their stand, only toughening this stand and refusing to really talk to each other. What is happening in the middle of this and because of this is that there is absolutely no business taking place inside the parliament. That is our key concern. We don't care right now at this point who blinks first, who takes the first step, who gives in. What we do want is constructive conversations, debates, policy making inside the parliament on Pegasus, on price hike, on the pandemic and several other issues. What will it take for this logjam to end? Will it even end this monsoon session? Let's ask the representatives of political parties joining me this evening. Mahesh Tapase, spokesperson for the NCP, Dr. Sunil Singh, leader of the JDU, Gurdeep Singh Sappal, national spokesperson for the Congress Party, Tuhin Sinha of the BJP, Professor Om Prakash Mishra of the TMC joining me this evening. Professor Mishra, let's start off with you tonight. What will it take for the parliament to function properly, at least for a few days, this monsoon session?
Good evening. Thank you. Parliament belongs to everyone, the government as well as the members of the opposition. And in fact, we would like the parliament to function in the most robust way possible. Now, the Prime Minister, you said, is angry. You might well have said frustrated. You might have said disappointed. It's all fine. In fact, it will require only the Prime Minister alongside his Home Minister. He can come to the Parliament and he should agree to a discussion on Pegasus issue. There are many issues that we would like to highlight. It is the farms law. It is the question of unemployment. It is the rising fuel prices. In fact, opposition has been looking forward to Parliament functioning. And what are we getting here? That opposition's voice is being muzzled. In fact, the notices under Rule 267, they have not been acted upon. And time and again, call attention motion raised by the opposition members that are not being adhered to. And you said about the wastage of time. I would also like to point out to you that in 10 working days of the parliament function, government has rushed through various bills, a total of 12 bills, and with a discussion, average discussion time of less than 7 minutes. So therefore, government is actually exploiting the situation in its favor by trying to turn a blind eye on the very legitimate demand related to the discussion of affecting our national interest and national security. Prime Minister should come forward. This is what the Venkaiah Naidu ji has said. He said that let the government also come forward. Onus is not on the opposition. Onus is equally, if not more, is on the government of the day. They are flying away from their responsibility. They want this logjam to continue. And they are taking advantage of this logjam to create a situation. They are passing the bill well under 7 minutes for every bill. We already know what has happened in the IT Ministry Standing Council, that the BJP members of parliament, they would not participate. So what they are fearful, only one question has been asked by the opposition. Government should come out very clearly. Whether government of the day has purchased the Pegasus software or not.
Okay, but Professor Mishra, we'll take it issue by issue. But are you saying the entire opposition stand of not allowing parliament to function in a planned manner is whether or not government says if they bought Pegasus or not? It surely can't boil down to that one answer, can it?
Well, this is very simple. That why this simple question should not be asked time and again, whether Pegasus has been used, employed, deployed by the taxpayers' money, whether government of India has bought this or not. And if they have, then they actually have to be accountable. And naturally, we are interested in raising so many questions. The country's economy, the farm laws, unemployment figures, this massive mismanagement of the of COVID by the center, all these are relevant issues. But the government of the day, they simply do not want the parliament to resume its normal functioning. They are rushing through the bills. It is not that the bills are not being passed.
Yeah.
Let me underline this. Actually, 12 bills have been passed by the two houses of the parliament on the government of India's prodding, on the executive's prodding, and then there is hardly any discussion. And so, therefore, it behoves the government that this would actually come clean and clear.
Okay.
So far as the Pegasus is concerned, let the opposition also get some accommodation, and then the government can go ahead and we can have the discussion on the crucial issues identified by your channel as very important for us.
Okay. Before I get Tuhin to respond, let me bring in one more opposition voice and let me go across to Gurdeep Singh Sappal. Mr. Sappal, can you give me precise examples of how is it that opposition's voice is being muzzled.
Today we heard two statements from the government. First, I'll come to that. One, that opposition doesn't want to discuss, debate, and government wants to debate. And second, that opposition unity is scattered, and some parties want to run the house, and Congress is not allowing it. Now, today at 3:15 p.m., there was a meeting of Business Advisory Committee in Rajya Sabha, BAC as we call it. I have with me the minutes of the agenda of BAC. I can send it across to your channel. I can share it with you. The agenda, there is no mention of any debate listed. There's no mention of debate. There's an annexure in it which says time already allotted by BAC. There's no debate. Government has not listed debate in any of its meeting, in any of its business advisory committee or list of business. They come out and tell people that we want a debate. But they will not list a debate. They will not tell what date, what time this debate will happen. So this is something very strange going on. There's a misinformation and factually incorrect statements being made by the government of India and its representatives. That is something very clear. What is opposition asking for? It is saying that let's have discussion under a particular rule. What is that rule? 267 in Rajya Sabha and adjournment motion in Lok Sabha. Are these rules very rare? No. I can read out to you. In August 2010, there was a similar debate on inflation. In December 2012, we had on FDI in retail. In April 13, we had on farmer suicide. In April 15, we had agrarian crisis debate. In August 16, we had Kashmir issue. And in November 16, we had demonetization. And after 2016, there has not been a single debate of this nature. So why this government for last 5 years has not taken up a rule? This rule exists in rule book. BJP, when it was in opposition, used to use it. Every year, at least one debate was happening. And now they say, you give us notice. The notices are there. The chairpersons of the both the houses, the speaker and the chairman Rajya Sabha, in their meeting in BAC, they say that government is not ready, so we can't take up the debate on Pegasus. Why government is not ready? Will government tell us? Why government is not ready? In last session, in February also, February-March session, they had a budget session, not a single debate was taken up in this house, in either of the houses, not a single debate. So government keeps on saying that we want debate, but it will not list a debate. It will not allocate a time for the debate. It is only interested in using parliament as a rubber stamp to push bills without discussion, without any deliberation.
To break the ice, to Insina. Okay.
Also, Second thing also, which is factually incorrect, because the Minister for Parliamentary Affairs said today that some parties want to run the house and Congress is not allowing. Today, because today only all the parties were collectively there at Constitution Club of India in a meeting. They went out on the streets to protest. Each and every party, 17 parties in total, are united. In a week, there have been 3 meetings of all the opposition parties together. 3 meetings. And the government has the... I can't even use the words to explain this situation, that officially misinformation is being dished out in this country and nobody is questioning, knowing fairly well that the entire opposition is united and the only demand is to come and debate. There's no other demand from opposition. When the COVID debate was listed last Tuesday, House functioned well. It did function. So what is the problem that government has to list the debate?
What is the problem that the government has to list the debate, Tuhin Sinha? Why can't you allot it some time and say, well, this is what we need to talk about, because 14 of the opposition parties are now insisting either this debate or nothing at all.
17 parties.
The entire opposition consumed with its wavered notions of Khela Hove. In Bengal, Mamata Banerjee used it as a wheel messaging for violence, and the opposition wants to use it in the parliament to create and manufacture chaos. Now, when it comes to, let me first answer the question, why no investigation? You know, the Honorable Minister, Ashwini Vaishnavji, has made a statement. We have seen how he behaved when he was making the statement, store papers. And mind you, I want to take you back 2 or 3 years. Derek O'Brien has been a repeat offender in Parliament. He has torn papers even in 2014 under the government when the Telangana bill was introduced. We've seen 2 years ago on the high-profile issue, Rahul Gandhi was winking when a lady defense minister was making a statement. They were, you know, creating paper planes and throwing it around. So please don't tell us, we don't debate. We have seen how you behave during debates. And in this session,
please,
particularly...
Please tell me when the debate will be listed, Turin.
So yes, there is a paucity of time. You know, look at the irony of the situation. When the COVID, when COVID was at its peak, these opposition parties used to insist on a, you know, emergency session of parliament. Now, 11 days have already been wasted out of 20 days, and we don't know when a third wave would come and another, you know, the country would again be stranded. So do they not appreciate the value of time? 135 crore rupees have been wasted. Do they not respect taxpayers' money? That is my simple question to them. Now, coming to another issue, we know that the Supreme, Honorable Supreme Court is already hearing a plea seeking court monitored inquiry. Do they not have the patience for another to at least allow the parliament to function? Please don't hold parliament to, you know, in this manner.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Sapal, please, can respond, please, and then I go to others. Yeah.
Number one. This entire now new argument has come today. Supreme Court case is there. It is sub judice. May I remind Mr. Sinha the period between 2010 to 14 when Supreme Court was hearing the cases of 2G and coal, and we did have so many debates in the House. This is nothing new. Are you saying that we should forget about the Parliament of India and leave every matter to the courts? Are you saying this? Are you undermining the authority of Parliament to discuss the issues that confront this nation? The Parliament is fully entitled to him to take up any issue, discuss it. The issue is not yet sub judice also. It is not yet sub judice technically. So please understand. And the second thing that you are saying about money. Let us not forget what we are saying. This entire Pegasus issue, where the government has supposedly spent 300 crore rupees, is also taxpayers' money. Are we to get into this bickering that...
I need to rebut this piece. The involvement of government, even if for a moment let us assume that Pegasus is used, the involvement of government in no way has been under suspicion. NSO has clarified that.
All the dealing with entire opposition is saying
Tuhin, whatever be the response, whether under suspicion, not under suspicion, using NSO's products, not using, legally using them, illegally using them, can all be discussed, debated inside the parliament. Now, you don't expect the country to actually read media interviews and what NSO has to claim via its statements and believe that's what it is. We would like to hear from the government being the operative part here. Mahesh Tapase, but if this logjam continues, neither are you getting any answers, nor are we getting any answers, neither are we seeing any business take place, then what's the point? We can't discuss fuel price, we can't discuss COVID, and we're not even discussing Pegasus.
Good evening, Tanvi, and all viewers. Let me tell you here that the BJP government, the central government, does not want to discuss any issues. They do not have any agenda to discuss the issues that legitimately have been put forward by the entire opposition. As far as what my friend Tuhin Sinha has said, I just want to remind him statements of two leaders who are of the BJP. None of them are there. They are not there with us anymore. I want to remind what Jaitley ji said on January 30, 2011. The leader of the opposition in the Rajya Sabha, Mr. Jaitley, said, "Parliament's job is to conduct discussions. But many a times Parliament is used to ignore such issues, and in such situation, obstruction of Parliament is in favor of the democracy. Therefore, parliamentary obstruction is not undemocratic," said by Mr. Jaitley. Outside the Parliament in August 26, 2020, says, "There are occasions when an obstruction in Parliament brings greater benefit to the country. Hence, our strategy does not permit us to allow the Parliament to use Parliament for debates without being held accountable. We do not want to give government an escape route through debate." September 7, 2012, Sushma Swaraj ji, she said, "Not allowing the parliament to function is also a form of democracy like any other form." Here, the entire opposition, the 14, 15, 17 members of the opposition, want a discussion. We are asking you to give, please, like last time I said on your show, Tanvi, if you remember, when is the parliamentary affairs ministers going to give us the agenda? That on this day, at this time, in the Rajya Sabha, in the Lok Sabha, we are going to talk on Pegasus. on this day, at this time, in the Rajya Sabha, in the Lok Sabha, we are going to talk on the farm bills. On this day, at this time, in the Lok Sabha, in the Rajya Sabha, we are going to talk about economics, about COVID situation, about losing jobs, about the downgrade of the projected Indian economy. So these are legitimate questions which we want to ask. I'm sure the Prime Minister is definitely upset with the opposition, and he has every right and reason to be. But we are asking legitimate questions. These are the same people who I've quoted examples from two of the greatest leaders that the BJP has ever seen. They are outstanding in their vocal performance in the Parliament. Sushma Swarajji, late Sushma Swarajji and late Jetli ji. But now today, when the entire opposition is asking the same BJP government to discuss on Pegasus, to discuss on COVID, to discuss on losing jobs, to discuss on farm laws, they don't have an answer. Why fuel prices are rising? We are more than 100 now everywhere for petrol prices, LPG prices rising. What is the answer that the government has? They don't have an answer. If they are so concerned about saving the people, and rightly, like my friend Tuhin Sinhaji said, 135 crores the figures that they get, we want to save the taxpayers' money, provided you have the answers for the taxpayer. As an opposition, we are asking you question on behalf of the taxpayers of this country, behalf of the citizens of this country, and we have every right to question you, Tuhin Sinhaji. You are in the government, you are driving the entire ship. So you are the one who's answerable to the every citizen of this country, whether he's a taxpayer or not a taxpayer. You have to answer the entire opposition. You have to satisfy our every query that our MPs in the parliament, the opposition MPs in the parliament, whether it's a single party, whether a single MP, does not matter. A single member of the parliament also has equal right, and you and the government have to answer him and satisfy him that yes, the government is heading in particular direction, whether that's right or wrong, only time will tell. But legitimate question raised by the entire opposition have to be answered, and BJP cannot escape from it.
But the point is that they are escaping without the house taking place or any proceedings taking place at all. So this strategy is not going to help if both sides keep toughening the stand. May I just bring in Dr. Sunil Singh here? Dr. Singh, deadlocks and log jams are not new. Opposition creating trouble, protesting is not new. But at some point, some parliamentary procedures need to come in place. There have to be conversations, backdoor negotiations, something to find a solution so that the house can function. Now, whose onus is that?
Tanvi, very pertinent question. Like, a Pegasus issue, when we had that, in Honorable Nitish Kumar has revealed and said, unambiguously said, that if there is suspicion in the mind of some people, Pegasus issue should be discussed and probe should be ordered. That's on one issue. But definitely, we do not agree with the opposition parties. They act in a very unfortunate manner and a very irresponsible manner. When they have to be in the parliament, they will be on the streets. And when they should be on the streets helping people during COVID times, they will be in the AC room tweeting, there is no vaccine, irresponsible tweets. And irresponsible people and hooligan people in the parliament, they will tear the papers apart. I don't know what is the problem with the opposition now. They have so many issues, if they have so many good issues, and they want to handle it in the streets, why can't they discuss properly in the parliament? When the bill is being passed, it's a very important thing for the development of the country. When the bill is being passed, they are very irresponsible. They don't do any study on the bill. They can't discuss. They will have it. They have just 5 points, trying to create the bedlam, trying to do the log jam, not functioning. I mean, it's very unfortunate, and the history will not forgive them. And as for the Pegasus, if they have so many things, the Supreme Court has taken up the issue. Why can't they discuss? And they're talking about that we are ready for discussion. The way they behave, who they are trying to fool, that they are ready to discuss. They're on the streets doing all kinds of things, tearing papers, all kinds of irresponsible things they are doing. So let the opposition, nothing is there. From the town time, whatever time is being left, let's not play with the taxpayers' money. India is looking at you people. My appeal to you through your channel and everybody, they should be in the parliament because it's for the parliament session.
But what did we write to say, Dr. Sunil Singh, that even your party chief and Bihar chief minister is suggesting an investigation so that the house functions? Because he also understands that this is the demand by a united opposition. There is no other way out of it.
Oh, yes. No, it's not demand. We have, our Honorable Nitish Kumar has unambiguously said, given so many controversies on the Pegasus issue is raising, people are having doubts about their phones being tapped, the matter should be thoroughly discussed and probed. It's one issue. Demanding something is one issue. But creating a hooliganism, tearing papers, creating a logjam, not allowing the parliament to function is another issue. In democracy, parliament session is very important for the policy making. So many good bills, so many bills are being passed thereby. And how many times they were spent on the bills? Nothing. Because they are not interested in reading about the bills. They want to come with the COVID times. COVID time, the supreme leader was just hiding in their bunker and tweeting irresponsible statement. No vaccine in July. July has come. About the vaccine, they have said all kind of irresponsible statement, Tanvi, when we know that the vaccine is the only way out to prevent or minimize the effect of third wave.
Okay.
But they had n number of things to say about the vaccine. These irresponsible leaders, they should do some soul searching. Parliament, taxpayers' money is being involved. Hundreds and hundreds of crores being involved. They should be in the parliament.
Yes.
And they should be in the parliament. Allow the parliament to function. Whatever they have to say, they should say there.
This is the point. Whatever you have to say, Gurudeep Sappal, say it in the parliament.
First, I'll respond to this vaccine issue in a minute. Let your viewers be reminded that the target, the goal of Government of India in February was to fully vaccinate, means two doses each, 30 crore people by 31st of July. And today we were at 31st July, it was 45 crore total, single dose to 45 crore, which includes double dose to some 7% people. The government gave four different versions in Supreme Court in last 4 months. And each time the government missed its own deadline. The last deadline was 51.5 crore. By 31st July, we ended up with 45 crore. So it is not that Rahul Gandhi or Congress leaders have been only tweeting. They have been raising the questions, asking the government, where is your plan? The government's plan was to have 10 to 12 crore co-vaccine every month. And we are stuck till today, only 4 crore vaccine till today. So now there's another definition of democracy today. You can't protest on the streets. That is being termed as, I don't know what word you used, Dr. Sunil, but it is undemocratic. You cannot ask questions in the parliament. You cannot ask for debate. That is undemocratic. You cannot go to court. You can go to court and courts will decide it. This is not democracy. The democracy is about making the government accountable in the house. What is wrong if opposition is asking the government to be accountable? But what is not surprising is the government's attitude. Because I'll tell you four things, Tanvi. In last 4 years, four things have happened. The standing committees have been made dysfunctional. Earlier, when UPA was in power, the opposition, the BJP, used to insist that even if there's a change of comma or a full stop in a bill, the bill should go to standing committee. But once they came to power, in NDA 1, in first government of Modi ji, only 25% bills went to standing committee. And after 2019, only 10% bills have gone to standing committee. 90% bills have passed without scrutiny. Second is CAG and PAC, Public Accounts Committee, which discusses the CAG report. In this year, so far, there have been only two CAG reports. Last year, it was 14 reports. And when UPA was in power, it was 55 reports. 2014-15, in 1 year, CAG gave 55 reports. You've killed CAG. You've killed standing committee. And the bills that you brought in last 4 years, through finance bill, you are trying to change major changes, major bills, like insurance sector, like other sectors. You just bring bills through finance bill on which Rajya Sabha cannot vote. So on every step, this government is trying to dilute the processes. On every step, it is trying to avoid accountability. On every step, it is trying to dilute the parliamentary procedures. So what is happening now is not an isolated incident. What is happening now is totally fits in with this government's attitude towards parliament. A lip service that parliament is great and we want parliament to function is not enough. As I said, please tell us, when will you have the debate? When the debate can be listed, please tell us. This is all opposition is asking for.
Yes, Dr. Sunil Singh.
Just one sentence. I would like to say to Mr. Sappal that I just meant that when you have to be in the parliament, you are on the street. You should be in the parliament at the point of time. And once when you have to be on the street, you are in your own bunker. That's what I meant, number one. And number two, please. About the vaccine, I again appeal you. Vaccine is being given smoothly everywhere by the government, and vaccine is not political, cannot be politicized. And thus, you people and every one of us should appeal to all the persons. Do the awakening, so the vaccine hesitancy should go off.
Dr. Sunil Singh, I agree with you. And I think all politicians should participate in getting rid of vaccine hesitancy. But right now, we're looking at a situation where we still need a lot more vaccines than the people who are willing to take the vaccine. So first, let's resolve the supply a part of the vaccines. And then when we have enough of vaccines and nobody coming in, we can, you know, see where the problem is and which are the pockets where vaccine hesitancy is still a big problem. For example, Tamil Nadu had a big vaccine hesitancy issue. By themselves, after the first three months, they've resolved it, and now they're queuing up in big numbers. But they don't have those many vaccines. Just 1 minute, Gurdeep, I want to go across to Mahesh on one other aspect.
One sentence, Tanvi.
Yes.
Let me again emphasize, there is no vaccine dearth or scarcity. Nowhere. It's India, we are proud of that, being such a large country.
You have no answer. I need to respond.
You and I disagree on it. Maybe on one of our vaccine debates, we will have you on the show along with Professor Om Prakash Mishra. But at the current pace of 30 lakh vaccinations per day is not the optimum speed. Every expert will tell you our entire future plan, economy, unlocking, everything depends on how many more people can get vaccinated, and we would want more. So, okay, in a way, you will say there is no shortage because we have 13 crore each month, 13 crore doses, but are they enough or do we need to be faster? That's where the debate is. Mahesh Tapase, I have one question before I let you go. There is also some amount of politics of convenience at play here. Your party leader is holding his meetings with opposition, with those in power. He's meeting the Home Minister over the issues that he thinks are important to discuss. And so that part goes on. But you as a party won't allow the House to function. How is that fair?
I think, Tanvi, in the picture that you saw today afternoon, you only could recognize, or probably the other leaders could only recognize, Mr. Sharad Pawar and the Home Minister himself. But there is one more gentleman, his name is Jayaprakash Nandegaonkarji, and he is the chairman of the Cooperative Sugar Factory Federation. Chairman of Federation of Cooperative Sugar Factories, and also Mr. Sunil Tatkar, who is a member of parliament from the NCP, from the Raigad constituency. So Mr. Pawar had met the Home Minister in his capacity as the cooperative minister. Today, the production cost of sugar to run a sugar factory, that on a cooperative basis, becomes extremely difficult. The cost of production of sugar is more than the sale price that the sugar bag is fetching these days in the market. So it is in that context that Mr. Pawar and the policy...
No, but I am not asking. So Mr. Tapase, sugar farmers and sugar mills and sugar cooperatives is a very key issue. I didn't ask you whether it was the sugar cooperatives or cooperative banks or any investigation against any party leader. I'm not asking you that. I'm simply making a point that when there are issues that you want to be addressed as your party leader and representatives of cooperatives, you are taking it up directly. But you won't allow the House to function where we can actually discuss these issues at length, transparently?
The issues that need to be discussed in the House, in the Parliament, are well laid out, well specified by the entire opposition. The government does not want to discuss those same issues. It's as simple as that. Let us know when the Parliamentary Affairs decides to discuss the gases issue. Let us know when they are wanting to discuss the farm laws. Let us know in the House, in the Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha, when they want to discuss about COVID deaths, and also about the vaccination. Now that we are facing again a crunch of vaccination. So like how Mr. Sunil Singh was saying in his earlier part, vaccination and government has been doing blah, blah, blah. If the vaccine diplomacy would have not started, or maybe it would have been restricted to very, very close group. I think we could have started vaccination in this country much, much, much before. Hmm. I do not deny that vaccine diplomacy was not important. But today, saving the life of Indian citizens is definitely the objective which of the government of India, and they should have been more focused on that. It had to be the Supreme Court to intervene for the government to formulate a policy on the import of vaccine, on the pricing of vaccination, how the government is going to deal with the vaccine manufacturers. If the Supreme Court would not have intervened, you know how the situation was, nothing was coming off. Every state had a different tendering process. The vaccine manufacturers were quoting different rates to different people. Then again, so many things would have come up in time to come.
Okay.
So I think Supreme Court made a good decision, and I'm happy that the government heeded to the decision, saving a huge embarrassment for the government itself and also facilitating the other states. So whatever good is that the government has done, we always appreciate that. But today, snooping on judges, snooping on reporters, journalists and leaders of the opposition and prominent politicians of the country, infringement of their privacy, infringement on their rights is something that the government has to answer. Who ordered the Pegasus software, which government agency is using, and against whom it has, the names which have come out. The government has to spell it very, very clearly.
Okay.
On the farm laws, people have been sitting on the borders of Delhi. It's almost 7, 8, 9 months, and the government has not been able to break the deadlock. We have seen cartoons floated by the BJP unit of Uttar Pradesh pulling that farmer leader by his hair. I mean, this is the kind of insensitivity that the Bharatiya Janata Party has towards the farmers and towards the leaders who are championing the cause of the farmers in the country.
Okay,
so
okay.
I think
let's take it one by one. And on the vaccine part, because Professor Om Prakash Mishra wanted to make a point on that as well. But Professor Mishra, give me one instance where the government has said, no, we will not talk about the vaccine policy in the parliament.
Not at all. In fact, we want this to be discussed. In fact, the entire country wants to discuss.
So why don't we allow parliament to function
for that? It's not that way. When the parliament functions in a normal, resumes it normally, you would find that the government of the day, they would be responding to the Rule 267, Rajya Sabha and adjournment motion in the Lok Sabha. They will come up and they will say that whether they have got Pegasus or not. And then, of course, the structured discussion should be taking place. Now, if you want to say that, well, government is ready to discuss all the issues, but not the Pegasus, let government say so. They are not saying that. They are saying that they are interested to discuss and debate. We have also the minister threatening that 350 members of parliament, Lok Sabha, they are interested to continue resumption. So what does that mean? That basically the opposition has no place in this country. In fact, we wanted to focus on COVID mismanagement and the farmers' issue, but then we did not know that in our functioning parliamentary democracy, something big actually has taken place for the last 3-4 years. We were not aware. So this is a matter of urgent attention. It's a national security issue. This Pegasus story has broken out only very recently. So therefore, the Prime Minister, why should we hesitate? If he is not the, he has not done anything wrong, why is he hesitating? Why the hell he is not saying that, whether they have bought it or not? This simple question is not being answered by the BJP apologists. This is what we want. This is what the entire country would like to do. And if you want to say that the opposition has no place, then they can very well pass all the bills. My colleagues here in the panelists, they have said that how the standing committees, they have lost their complete value. I pointed out that our leader, Derek O'Brien, has been very insistent saying that less than 7 minutes time has been devoted to pass 12 bills in the current Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha session. So therefore, let the government of the day come out clean. Let them sit the opposition party. We are ready to cooperate. We are ready to raise all the relevant issues. So that is not being done by the government. You are talking about responsibility. What about accountability of the government?
Yes. I am all for accountability of the government and responsibility of the opposition to ask the right questions. But I am all simply saying that if you're going to hold on to one issue and not allow the entire parliament to function for an entire session, then we're really not going anywhere and getting answers to any question, whether it's your question on vaccine or your question on fuel prices or any other issue. Gurdeep, I know you want to make a point, but let me also just bring in, two of our panelists who are joining us right now, Ghanshyam Tiwari of the Samajwadi Party and Saravanan of the DMK. Ghanshyam, valid issues that the opposition may have, but there is no point in simply standing outside holding placards and cycling around if you don't allow a discussion inside the parliament on it.
Well, good evening to you, Tanvi, and to my fellow co-panelists and your viewers. If you know that the doctor who's turned out as specialist is actually a quack, would you go to the same doctor no matter what the illness is? This is exactly what this government has become. It has turned out to be a quack. The entire world knows that Pegasus is a real issue, and there's only the quacks will tell you that it's a fake issue. Countries which are associated with it, they are investigating this firm. And only NSO is defending itself, and Government of India and BJP is defending NSO. Even JDU, which is an ally of NDA, is demanding a probe. Nitish Kumar, who's a constitutional authority, sitting chief minister, is demanding a probe. So when the government turns out to be a quack, it is important that the entire opposition, which actually represents the conscience of the nation, this government does not have 51% vote. The opposition has more than 51% vote. We represent the conscience of the nation. If this government is not telling, why did it snoop journalists, women, constitutional authorities, its own sitting ministers, and not allowing a probe, a debate to happen in parliament? We do not trust this government to have an honest discussion on petrol prices. We don't trust this government to have an honest discussion on farmer issues, on corona. In fact, the entire nation was stunned when they said that nobody died of oxygen shortage. So clearly, this government is out to set the lowest bar in the parliament history of India. I can tell you one final thing. In the last 7 years, Mr. Modi has been the prime minister. There have been more Sundays than number of sittings of the parliament. They are the only party that disrupt parliament when they are in opposition. In December 2018, the news was that they used AIDMK to disrupt parliament. This was the news on major channels. Mm. And then they ensured that parliament session does not happen because of Gujarat elections. Mm. They can use their allies, which are not even formal allies, to disrupt parliament. When they are in power, they can disrupt parliament by themselves by rescheduling a parliament session for Gujarat election because they thought that people of Gujarat will shunt them out.
Okay, so Tuhin wants to respond to you, Ghanshyam. Yes.
In the last few years, for the first time, we have seen parliament function even beyond midnight. So I don't know what my friend Ghanshyam Tiwari is talking when he says that we don't allow parliament to function. Debates on Kashmir and other important issues have gone well past midnight, and you have reported it. That's number one. Number two, the Pegasus has been found in 45 countries. Now, three countries, to the best of an inquiry. The one size fits all cannot apply to all the countries. The kind of information, the kind of evidence which is present in each country, should be the starting point of investigation. Now, in India, whatever reports have come out are so flimsy that they don't even validate an investigation. And even then, since the Supreme Court is hearing the matter, wait for 2 days, let the parliament function. Fact of the matter is that we want to discuss real issues because, I wish they had discussed petrol price in parliament. I wish they had discussed COVID vaccination in parliament. But they are obsessed with a flimsy issue because they know that the government's handling of the COVID crisis has been combative and resurgent, and they don't have much to crib about.
I don't know why you call the issue of an allegation of Indians being snooped upon as flimsy.
So the kind of information they have come up with, we asked them to file an FIR. None of them had the audacity to do, they had the courage to do that. So now when the government's stand is very clear. If at all any spying has happened, it has happened under the mandated provisions of the Indian Telegraph Act, which by itself makes it clear that Pegasus has not been used. Pegasus technology is a new technology. We have never, NSO has made it clear that it has never had any dealing with the...
Your minister's name is there. Why don't you ask the minister to file an FIR?
I can respond to this.
The minister's name is there. Let him file an FIR. Two of the minister's names are there in the list. And so this has been discussed there in the...
Minister believes that there is no story here. He obviously doesn't think that there is any value to those allegations or his own name being on that list. Yes, Gurdeep Sappal first, and then we're going across to Saravanan.
This is interesting that BJP says, and all spokespersons of BJP have been saying, go file an FIR. Mr. Sinha, please tell me under which provision of IPC can I file an FIR on national security matter? How do I go? Will any thana, any police station entertain an FIR on a national security issue? National security issues are the responsibility of Government of India. Tomorrow you get a tip-off from IB regarding a transgression at LOC or from POK, somebody comes in. You'll wait for an FIR to take an action. It's a national security issue. Please understand, the Chief Justice of India's office has been snooped. The Election Commission of Election Commissioner's phone has been snooped. It is the Chief Minister's, it is the sitting ministers, the media, the leader of opposition, the RNAW, sitting colonels, sitting BSF officers. They all have been, the charges are that their phones have been snooped. This is a national security matter, and this is, you are making it so flimsy to go and report a national security matter in a FIR, in a thana. This is not how the countries are dealt with. The countries, there's a responsibility of the Government of India to ensure that A, the national security is taken care of, and B, it is also an issue of fundamental right of privacy.
Yeah,
the right to privacy has been...
So people can individually go even perhaps to the police and as an individual to find out who's spying on me from my phone. But it's a matter of national security.
You can't go to police for national security issue.
Which is where the government needs to come in. The argument that now that the Supreme Court is hearing, so we don't need to explain or we are not answerable to the parliament also doesn't work. The government is answerable to the parliament on extremely crucial issues, Sarvanan. But...
Yeah.
While you strive to make the government answerable on Pegasus inside the parliament, you need to also ensure they're answerable on other issues, which can only happen if everybody sits inside Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha and allows the proceedings to function.
Tanvi, yeah. We are prepared to sit
Tanvi,
in Lok
this
Sabha
is one way.
Yes,
this
Mr. Sapan, just this one minute. Way. Let me bring in Sarvanan. Yeah.
Yeah. Tanvi, this is one way. The opposition decides which is the best way to take on this government on a specific issue. And they have all concluded that abstaining the parliament and blocking the parliament is the best way. And that is the reason why this is becoming a national issue. Every day this is being discussed. So their strategy is paying off. The BJP, which has never seen such unity among the ranks of the opposition, is now running scared. They have never seen. They have always used this divide and policy. The opposition, 19 of the opposition parties, 17 of the 19 opposition parties have participated, have come together and wants to make the government, the BJP government, accountable for the Pegasus. And see what the BJP spokesperson coming and saying? Oh, nothing. They have followed the law. If they had followed the law, Pegasus, no Indian phones should have been infected. But there is solid proof that phones in India are infected. So this comes to the earlier argument. If the Indian government has not done this, if the enemy state or anybody else had done that, then this is compromising national security. The BJP, which thumps its chest whenever you speak national security in the same line, what are you doing? Why are you not coming out with the truth? NSO has made it very, very clear that it gives this licenses only to the government. See, we are every day we are being forced to say this again and again. Because the BJP tries to bring out alternate facts. They think they can just how they have managed headlines in the last 7 years. They think that they can manage this Pegasus issue. But I think they have miserably failed on the count. And how long more they're going to peddle this ridiculous FIR theory?
Yeah.
The police station, which has got 5 streets under its jurisdiction, it is going to investigate NSO, which is an Israeli firm, and it tells only to the government. Which police officer, which station office officer will have the courage to summon anybody?
Yeah. At some point, Tuhin, you're telling me that a police officer in a police station in Mumbai or Chennai or somewhere can issue summons to the sitting ministers to come and answer on Pegasus?
First of all, let me remind Mr. Sapal that at the core of it is the issue of infringement of personal privacy, under which he has
We are talking of national security. For us, it's a national security issue. Can you please tell us Pakistan has not done it? Are you sure Pakistan has not done it? If you have not done it, then Pakistan may have done it. How can you rule it out? Have you investigated it?
Okay, let him respond. Yes, Tuhin, respond. Yeah.
names have cropped up. You know, it's entirely speculative. In fact, Amnesty Israel has been
investigation. Investigate and say it is not there.
I mean, we have made our stand clear that there has to be a little more substance in your allegations. Right now, it is absolutely flimsy. First of all, even Amnesty has used the term, potential targets, which by itself means that in the last 3 years, they are not sure that all the names and some of these claims, 500 names, they are not sure whether, if at all, any of them were targeted.
But 10 of them were. But according to their claim, according to their own reports, even since you are taking those reports so seriously, they are saying at least 10 of them were. Are those 10 people not Indian citizens?
How are you sure that there has been no snooping? How are you sure? Please tell the country this. Have you done any investigation?
Because they have snooped and they want to deny it.
He has been snooping upon you, then your actions need to be held accountable for that. The government has nothing to do with it. That is what our stand has been.
But how can government say nobody else has done it? I say Pakistan has done it. How do you refute it?
You know, the rival leaders of Rafal may have done it. Because the way the opposition was leveling allegations on Rafal, it almost seemed that they were acting at behest of the foreign arms dealers.
That has proved to be correct.
Please investigate, Congress people. Tell they have done it. But spying has taken place. Investigate in the first place.
So far.
So okay. No, so here is the point. Firstly, we don't know who's behind it. If at all this surveillance was happening at a large scale or small scale, and who's behind it. And that is where it boils down to as part of an investigation that needs to be done. But again, we come back to the same point, Ghanshyam. We can't, the opposition can't simply obsess over the fact that first tell us whether you bought Pegasus or not. Even if the government tells you that they have bought Pegasus or haven't bought Pegasus, that's not going to give you answers to the rest of it. Then you will have to change your goalpost and find other reasons to obstruct the parliament.
I'll say two things, Tanvi. One is that I'm actually surprised at this list, that they did not snoop Mr. Mallya, they did not snoop Mehul Choksi, they did not snoop Nirav Modi. Even if they had done that, I would have given them that this, they are patriotic. They had an intention to save those who were stealing billions from people of India. They did not snoop that. Second, that if Tuhin and people in the government are saying that we don't know who did it, but if it is done, it's a matter of national security. And then if it is proven that only government of India can do it and they did it, then either this government will fall or the Home Minister has to resign or the Prime Minister has to resign. Because there are only these three people, three actions that are possible. If the government is charged with this level of snooping and they accept it, the Home Minister has to go. There is no locus standi, there is no moral standing left. You cannot snoop from Mali to a judge and say that we are a formidable government building $5 trillion economy and taking India to 21st century. This is what this government is today. So it is a formidable matter. And only when they prove that they are not quack, they are a real government who care for national security, then can we discuss with them what are they going to do with respect to economy, massive unemployment, potential of third wave, vaccines. Everything is important, but this government is not they are the quacks on the job. So far, this is what it seems.
Okay, let me ask this one question to Professor Mishra. Professor Mishra, the Bengal government has set up a judicial panel now,
yeah,
led by a retired Supreme Court judge to look into this matter. Why are you still blocking the parliament on this issue?
See, that we have done this as per the existing law under Section 3 of the Act of 1952, and this will be probed. However, this actually does not concern West Bengal only. It is not only that our leader Abhishek Bandyopadhyay was snooped upon, Prashant Kishore was snooped upon. There are yet other people who possibly may have been a target. Our Chief Minister of West Bengal, she herself was a target because these two people were all the time keeping in touch. And there was an attempt to affect, influence, impact the West Bengal election. However, this the same thing actually had happened in 2019 also. Now we do know that same thing actually happened in regard to the change of the government brought about illegally by the BJP in Karnataka. So therefore, BJP always talks about national interest, national security. I will second Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari when he says that it's a national security issue. As a former member of National Security Advisory Board to Government of India, I can tell you very emphatically that this is a very, very serious issue. And this particular issue must be answered. Government has to be accountable.
Okay.
And then there is no reason for them to deny it if they have not done any wrongdoing. But to the extent that they are denying, that they are actually evading it, to the extent that they are trying to bulldoze it, they actually are on the wrong. And so therefore, we want the entire opposition, want the Prime Minister and the Home Minister to come to the Parliament and to, you know, make a statement whether they have purchased it or not, whether they have used it, misused it as a weapon, so as to convert India from a constitutional democracy to a surveillance state.
Okay, what would then Dr. Sunil Singh, you know, the ally of the BJP, your party and your party leader, advise them to just go ahead and order an investigation and hold a conversation inside the parliament? You've heard all opposition party representatives here. They themselves are saying that never before have they united in such a manner as they have on this issue. So they're not going to be relenting right now.
Yeah, first of all, I would say that I totally disagree with Mr. Saravanan, who justifies the parliament logjam and say it's okay, by doing this, we are bringing this this topic to discussion on a national issue. I say parliament should function as like a parliament and there should not be a logjam and wasting taxpayers' money. I don't agree with you, Mr. Saravanan. And as for things, Mr. Sappal, he says I cannot file an FIR. Let me tell you, if I feel that my phone is being tapped, I have the locus tendi to file an FIR. About that, Mr. Mishra, the way he was saying my so many and so and so leaders' phone were tapped, they have the locus tendi to file an FIR at least and take the issue. And as for the Pegasus row, whatever controversy is being created, rightly or wrongly, we don't know. But Honorable Nitish Kumar says, yes, if there's so much of controversy is being raised, the matter should be discussed and probed. Our stand is very clear. But on the pretext of Pegasus, you cannot hold the parliament to ransom. You cannot let loose sloganeering, tearing the papers, doing all kind of thing on the streets. When you have to be on the streets during the COVID times, you were not there. You were not there. And when you have to be in the parliament, you're on the streets. I don't see it as a good thing.
Okay. Well, I'm almost out of time, but 30 seconds to Saravanan to respond to this. Yes.
Yeah. See, what I'm asking is, this is a time-tested tactic. Parliamentary logjams, which has been effectively used by the BJP. They made a mountain out of a molehill. They said a JPC has to be set up. The then UPA relented. There was an investigation. Then we know what happened. All of them were acquitted. Come clean. We want an inquiry. Why the government is running shy of an inquiry? This is the way we can make the government accountable. We know what happens inside the majoritarian parliament. Unfortunately, BJP has the majority. We are talking about discussion of bills. There is no discussion of the bills in the parliament.
Yeah.
Only 10% of the bills in the BJP government is being discussed. That is 1 in 10 of the bills is discussed.
Essentially, they don't really need you, because if they want to pass legislations, they can do it without any debate also, whether you are in the house or not in the house.
That may not be fair. Let me complete this. See, there is no suggestions. The suggestions given by the opposition party members had never been, none of the bills. They just wanted to refer it to a select committee. Even that is not being headed by the BJP.
Okay.
That is the problem here.
Okay. On some of the bills and the responses that opposition have given, we will have a debate another day, completely out of the time. So I'm going to thank all the panelists for joining me right now. But you know, what came out of this conversation and what was actually also being debated towards the end? This is an age-old tactic used in parliamentary procedures, which is to bring in a deadlock, logjam, opposition uniting, cornering the government on an issue to get more and more political mileage, to create noise about the issue that they want to be seen linked with, where they want to create the perception. And all of that is fine. And the UPA can say that the NDA does it, the NDA NDA can say, the UPA can used to do it. The other parties can come in and say, well, Congress did it, BJP did it, so why can't we? All of that is fine. But at some point, you need to draw the line. Yes, when the BJP was in the opposition and UPA was in power, they too wasted session after session of the parliament with their opposition politics, just as it is happening now by the other side. But it's not fair. It's not fair on you and me. It is a duty and the right of the opposition to ask questions to the government, to make the government accountable inside the parliament. But not only via protests and placard holdings and sloganeering and obstructing the parliament, by in fact asking the right questions on the floor of the house, forcing the ministers to give the answers that the entire country would want to hear on key issues. With just a few days remaining, one can only hope at some point this deadlock ends. Whoever is the first side to take a step forward must do it now in the interest of people. You'll probably gain some political points for that if you give in and be the first one to reach out and allow the parliament to function. Think about it. Thank you so much for joining us.